drag with that wind. That wind is cranking. Yeah, he's going off the pilings. We're going to wave to our friends down here in the pontoon boat. There's some of our subscribers. Thank y'all. Thank y'all for watching. That dock, boy. Although it's not a posted wake zone right here, it's a common courtesy thing. There's winds too stiff. Lane 8 and 9. They're going to go ahead and take both up. If I had any advice today, stay away from lane 7, 8, and 9. With the wind the way it is, you're definitely gonna want to stay on these inside lanes. That'd probably be in the 1 to 5 range. So just my thoughts. We're gonna go ahead and get balls deep here on lane 8 and 9 with the second attempt, man in the water. Wish him luck. Are you fisting me? They got way too much money and not enough knowledge. Folks, if you're not yet subscribed to the Big Dan Show, here is the time to do it. Smash that like button, smash that bell. You want to subscribe and be notified every time we drop new content here on the channel. Wave runner will be on there just fine. And back to lane 8 and 9 here, where we're gonna watch this old sea chaser try to chase his way up to the ramp and get on that trailer somehow. Give me something I can use now.
Check out your channel every now and then just to make sure I'm not on it. Were you over at the other one earlier today?
Yeah, I drove by there a little bit.
My wife and I drove by, I said, that's that Big Dan guy right there.
Yeah.
What do you want me to do? I'm like, just going to do anything stupid.
Just keep on driving. Thanks for saying hello.
Well, it looks like nothing's changed down here except for they got it between the pipes. They're running the keel up on the starboard side of the trailer, just tearing that gel coat up. But they're back off and they're gonna go for a fourth attempt here. I may run down there in a minute. I hate to see them tear this boat up, but I may run down there and ask them if they want me to help them. Hey, girl. I'm back over here on lane 8 and 9. I cannot help myself but to stay over here. Coming over here like they're gonna try to help. You gonna help them?
I'm thinking about it. I'm trying to get my boat in.
I was thinking about it too. I was like, I ought to go over there and help them.
My truck's right next to them.
They're gonna tear the gel coat up. Yeah. What's that?
I'm not getting my boat here.
Yeah, exactly. It's a miracle. Hold on now, they're pushing. He ain't finished yet. I need to get that dang motor down. Old Seahorn, that's a cool boat. All right, what are they doing now? Easy with the music now, easy with the music. My man right here, he said, dude, I ain't going down there near them. I ain't getting my boat near them. I said, yeah, I don't blame you. They're regulars here at the launch. Watch how they get in here on this dock. This is the beauty in having the joystick controls.
Whether you're using it for trailering or docking, backing into slip, whatever it is.
This is about a $25,000 option if you put it on your boat. If it didn't come from like this from the factory. But most of these newer boats have it. Making it look easy.
Oh man. Twist it, comes out of punch.
Is that a 31?
What's that?
Is that a 31?
30. It's a 305, yeah.
That's a sick boat.
Yeah.
What's the asking price on it?
What's that?
What's the asking price?
255 there.
That ain't too...
Half the door, that thing we put on is 270.
That ain't bad at all.
Half a 30 foot.
You found a boat.
Yeah.
Put a lot more than that on a 27 with a big name boat.
I know, Contender or anything like that, it's freaking...
It runs too. It's
350. What's that?
Well, I said it runs too. We got it up to 60.
Dang, that's fast. How many gallon tanks you got on it?
225.
Perfect. Doing rigs trip easy with no extra fuel cell.